Okay, so notice that this is almost the same graph as the one we just drew. The only difference is that we have this plus 3. So when we think about that plus 3, that's a vertical shift up 3. So that means basically we're taking the graph that we drew just a second ago, and we're shifting the whole thing up 3. So let's think about how we would do this. If we hadn't just drawn that other graph, let's just think about how we would think through this. I would again start by drawing the shape of my graph. It's a sine curve that's reflected, so it's going to look like this, right? So I always like to draw that shape, so I remember to draw the right shape when I'm putting it on my graph. My amplitude is still going to be 2 because that a value is negative 2, telling me that we have both a vertical stretch of 2 and we have a vertical reflection. My b value is still 1. It still hasn't changed, so my period is still going to be 2 pi. Now, a phase shift is what we call a horizontal shift. So we talked about that at the beginning here, and a horizontal shift would be our c value, but we do not have a c value. It just says x inside those parentheses. So we do not have a horizontal shift, so we could say 0, right? It shifts 0 to the left or right. But for a vertical shift, now we see that d value. We do have a vertical shift up 3. We continue to have a domain of negative infinity to infinity. But because of that vertical shift up 3, our range is going to change a little bit. So before, we had it at 0, we were going up to 2, down to negative 2. Well, now if that whole thing is shifted up, right, we're going to shift that whole thing up 3. Well, now my midline is going to be at 3 instead of at 0, right? And so when it goes up 2 from that, we're going to reach all the way up to 5. And when it goes down 2 from that, we're going to reach all the way down to 1. So notice the shift up 3 affects all 3 of these values, the midline, the maximum, and the minimum. So our range is now going to go from 1 until 5. So that is the big difference in this graph. So let's give this a try. So I'm going to draw in my y-axis. And just like before, I'm going to have those x-axis labels. They didn't change because the period didn't change. So I'm going to drop those in there. And now I'm going to make sure that I need to cover that whole range. So I'm going to make sure that I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way up to 5. And we did figure out that our midline is going to be at y equals 3. It's no longer at y equals 0 because we shifted it up 3. Okay, so I'm going to draw in my midline here. So here's my midline. And then I see my maximum, right? My amplitude is 2. So I see my maximum up at 5 and down at 1. And I'm going to draw in that same shape. So I'm going to start on the midline. And I'm going to go down to the minimum, back to the midline, up to the maximum, back to the midline. So if we were to look at this graph compared to our other graph, see, here's this one, here's this one, they're exactly the same graph, except everything has shifted up 2 in this new graph, okay, and that, or up 3, sorry, because of the vertical shift up 3.